Good Rock It Out Wednesday morning. On today's news, we have an important update for StuCo members.
Also, the homecoming parade is coming up. Get with your clubs and sports to help prepare.
All of this along with your weather with Markwell Holman and your sports with Brad Ross. Good morning, he's Damon Brown.
And she's Cicely Mathenia. Today is Wednesday, September 19th, and here are today's news and announcements.
The Truman Patriots Club will be selling Truman apparel at the homecoming game as well. ESL Cultures Club will meet today at 2:30 in the lecture hall. They will be having food and games and also learn about cultures around the world. Any student who is interested in learning more about world cultures is invited to attend. FCA is having a meeting next Tuesday, September 25th at 6:30 in the band room, and there will be a guest speaker and lots of food. So come and join us. If you have questions, contact Mr. Sapp in room 216 or Mrs. Costello in room 114.
Pre-order homecoming shirts this week during lunch for $8. Tickets are also on sale this week for $8 and next week for $10. Guest forms for homecoming are now available in the main office. Make sure to fill these out today if you want a student from another school to come to the dance. Make sure you get these forms to your guests and get them on time. Remember to all StuCo members, don't forget about decorating the dance this Saturday at 7 a.m. Also, don't forget to sign up for the Cozy Calendar and join Facebook and Twitter. We still have a few StuCo shirts that need to be picked up if you forgot to buy one. We have a few left for $13 in room 134.
Today is Rock It Out Wednesday. Thursday is Throwback Day. Seniors dress like old people, juniors like adults, sophomores as teeny boppers, and freshmen as babies. Friday is Blackout. All students need to wear black while staff members wear yellow. Make sure to participate every day. The Independent School District College Fair will be held at Chrisman on October 4th from 6:30 to 8 p.m. Over 60 colleges, universities, and technical schools will be there. The Gay Straight Alliance is having a meeting after school today in room 218. Remember to bring your $10 dues.
And here is our homecoming week weather with Markwell Holman, the man.
The man. The man. Before I say anything, I would like to start off by saying today's gonna be a good day. It's all about this, rock and roll, all about this. Our current conditions are 56 degrees. Later on today, it's gonna get to 82, and tonight's gonna drop back down to 50. Tomorrow, we will experience some strange clouds. It's gonna be partly sunny. Do not ask me what that is. 5-day forecast, please. We're going to start off, the rest of this week is going to be sunny, high 70s, getting to high 60s a little bit, and coming back next week, we're going to get 80. Sunny, car wash week. That's how I do it. Back to Anchor's desk.
This Thursday is the class picture for seniors. Make sure you report directly to the big gym right after second block. Order forms are in the main office. Please stop by and pick this up, as you must turn it in the day the picture is taken. The homecoming parade is Thursday. The parade is free and includes candy and fun. The parade starts at 5 p.m. and circles Truman, going out of Oldham, down 35th, up Hawker, up 32nd, and up Noland into the side entrance. We hope to see you there. All voting for homecoming kings and queens has started. Make sure you visit this site. Voting ends Friday at 3 p.m.
Luff Elementary needs A-plus students to come help out with the PTA BAM dance on September 28th from 5:30 till about 8. See Ms. Dendish by September 25th to sign up. Volunteers are needed for a pumpkin patch in Independence. Hours are available of October. See Ms. Dendish for details as this contributes towards A-plus and community service. Please sign up by September 27th. Now, here's Brad Ross with this morning's sports report.
Good morning, Patriots. Last night, the varsity cross country had another great showing last night at Cole Rockhold came in first place at the city championship with a time of 16:21. Haley Kramer finished second for the girls varsity with a time of 21:58. For the JV boys, Ryan Jaquack placed first with a time of 18:40. The boys varsity and JV took the team titles while the girls varsity took second overall. The team's next competition is the KC Metro invite on September 29th. Be there. In volleyball, the varsity girls lost a very tight match to Park Hill last night, 26-24 and 25-22. The team is now 10-7 on the year and will face Park Hill South on the road Thursday. JV and the freshman A team also took a loss to Park Hill, while the freshman B team came up with a win. The girls tennis teams came up short Monday and Tuesday in a dual play. Varsity lost to Liberty North 7-2, and a singles victory from Shelby Kalfas, and a doubles victory from Kalfas and Kelsey Hanaway. The JV won their duel to Liberty North 6-1. Madison Graham, Lucy Ray, and McKenna Miller, and Desiree Fike won their singles matches, while Haley Crownover and Hallie Schutz took their doubles match. The varsity girls came up short against Park Hill South 9-0, and the JV took a loss 7-2 with a doubles victory from Schultz and Ray and Crownover and Emily Frazier. Team host Park Hill at Santa Fe Park at 4 p.m. Thursday. Softball continues to dominate as the girls took the Blue Spring South tournament by avenging a 2-1 pool play loss to Blue Springs by topping the Wildcats 3-1 for the championship. They knocked off Notre Dame, DeSion, Ray Peck, and Ozark to take their third tournament title. They followed that up with a victory over St. Joe Central Monday and took 8-0 shutout at Park Hill last night. The record now stands at 7-1 in conference and 21-2 overall. They host Lee's Summit West on Thursday at Adar Park to soccer. The boys' soccer team is on the road against Lee's Summit West, and the girls' golf team takes on Staley in the Northland this afternoon. And back to the desk with Damon.
Thanks, Brad. CIA Club is canceled this week. If you're interested in Scholars Bowl, please come to a meeting on the 24th or 25th right after school in room 303. Please see Mrs. Gravely or Mr. Hermanson if you have questions. Don't forget to nominate your favorite teacher or patriot of the month. Forms to nominate are in Mrs. Evans' room, room 100, and are dropped off there as well. Vote for who you think deserves these titles.
Today for lunch, we're having a chicken quesadilla with sour cream and salsa.
And on the grill line, we are having chicken corn dog with baked fries or a cheeseburger.
For the latest school headlines, visit CHS Media online and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Just text 404-404 and type follow at THS Media. If you want to keep on top of the school news, just click subscribe on our YouTube channel.
If you would like your birthday announced or other announcements, please email Mr. Merrithew the day before by 3:20. Include Kathy Glasgow on general announcement emails. Any emails sent after this time will not be included in the next day. In the email, please list the dates you would like your message to appear on the morning news.
This week is Teen Read Week. We encourage everyone to read as much as they can and take AR tests throughout this week.
Remember, if you take an AR test this week, you'll get a special treat.
My favorite book to read is...
What is your favorite book, Damon?
I read Goosebumps in third grade.
That's nice.
That counts.
My favorite book I have read recently was Revolution by Jennifer Donnelly.
Oh.
Rock it out. That's all we have for you today, Truman.
Have a marvelous Wednesday, and don't forget, tomorrow is Throwback Thursday, so wear those gold chains.